Hey guys, this is David Kwan here. This is a video response to a blog that a user has written on IGN.com. The user being Macabre Milkman, and he wrote the blog, Why David Cage is Wrong and Why Heavy Rain Sucks. Yeah, a pretty sensationalist title there, but you'd be wrong to mistake it. If you think it's like a troll blog, it's not. It's actually a very well thought out, it's a very long blog about why he disagrees with a lot of things that David Cage has recently said, especially in the PS4 announcement. And also he kind of just analyzes the story of Heavy Rain and just picks holes and just brings out all the plot holes in that game, most of which I actually do agree with. But I'm responding to this video because I disagree with him on one main thing. But let's kind of go over point by point. The first thing he talks about is David Cage's vision and his idea about the gaming industry. So David Cage wants this industry to grow up and to tell mature stories, and he likes to make games that are about emotions, and he wants to create emotion. We all know this, you know, that David Cage is this kind of game maker. The thing that bothers Macabre Milkman, and actually to me too, is when in the PS4 announcement, he brought up this picture of what the PS4 graphics are capable of and stuff. And with the trailers of The Beyond and things of that nature, Macabre Milkman is disappointed that David Cage is focusing so much on graphical prowess to tell emotions. And his point is that you don't need amazing, powerful hardware to have emotion in games, to tell amazing stories in games. And, you know, there's plenty of games where, you know, I think Bioshock was one of the examples he mentioned in his blog, where the protagonist you're playing is, you don't know what his face looks like, he doesn't really talk, he's that emotionless character, and yet that game was able to have an emotional storytelling. And so that's the main criticism of David Cage there, and you don't need to focus so much on graphics, on so much on who the actors are in your game. I know that one of the biggest thing that Beyond is going for right now is that Ellen Page is a voice actress, and that Willem Dafoe is an actress in there. So it's a valid point, I think. This medium as a whole, there actually has been great successes, and especially in recent times with things like Journey, The Walking Dead, these games that are brings you different emotions, and it doesn't need the best graphics to do so. But at the same time, I understand where David Cage is coming from. He is trying to hype up his game. He's trying to hype up the Sony's products like the PS3 and the PS4. And so he has to talk about technology. He's a very technology-driven guy, I think, which in a way I understand. In some ways it's kind of disappointing, but he is very technologically driven guy, and he believes that to immerse you into this universe, you need to the wrinkles in a character's face and the facial expressions of a character means a lot to immerse you into the players into the game world. That's kind of his point, which is an interesting point, but I also do agree with Macabre Milkman that to have emotional storytelling in games, you don't need the technology. I do think one of the problems in this industry right now as we're moving into the next generation is this insane focus on graphics and horsepower and such. I really think in order for games to continue to move forward, because I am an optimist in this industry, that I think games have come a long way, but in order to keep going further and further, it's all about the creativity. Even with a crappy hardware, there's still so many ideas that we have not even explored in this industry. And I think that's really great. I think that's really what needs to be focused on more. And a lot of these CEOs and a lot of these game makers are making comments where it seems like, well, we can't pursue our vision that we have because of the limited technology. So this awesome new technology allows us to do this, which is horseshit, you know. So there's that. Now, his whole point about Heavy Rain is an interesting one. He brings out a lot of plot holes here and there, a lot of which I do actually agree with, such as Jason not even being hit by a car, car going slow, and Ethan shields him, but Jason ends up dying. Why? Because he has to die in order for that story. There's a lot of points in that game where things happen for arbitrary reasons. Things happen because David Cage, the writer, has to have that happen in order for this scene to have this emotion in them. So Heavy Rain is really guilty of that. And there's a lot of moments that actually does pull you out of the immersion of the game experience because it doesn't make sense. The plot hole is there. I mean, the big reveal that Shelby Scott is the killer was done in a way that was manipulative. It kind of just, you were, the player, while even controlling Scott Shelby, was lied to the entire time. You can press a button and actually go into Shelby Scott's head and hear what he is thinking. He never actually thinks as a killer, which he is. So that's the way, so Macabre Milkman is very angry at the way that this game does this. The game actually lies to you. There's so many different plot holes. The voice acting, especially in English, is very problematic. When I play the game, I actually thought it was like a European city, but it actually is an American city. So the fact that all these things can happen in America is not realistic storytelling. So he brings up a lot of plot holes here that I agree with. But at the same time, to say that overall makes Heavy Rain a bad story, I think is kind of missing the point. And he brings up the point that Heavy Rain doesn't move the gaming medium forward, it brings it down, and he does, you know. But I actually think Heavy Rain has had a huge impact in the gaming industry because of its success. There were many games like Heavy Rain that came before it, that came after it, but I think Heavy Rain, because of its commercial and critical success, moved the medium forward. It's because it's one of the few games where a character that you control can die, and that is not a game over. The game carries over. But even the little story chase choices that you make in the game continue over. So I think the biggest draw of Heavy Rain is not a great story, which can be argued that it doesn't have a great story because of its all the plot holes. But it has a lot of compelling scenes, a lot of dramatic scenes, and just the moments that are like, holy shit, you know? But the story is designed so that you can kind of craft it the way you want it to go. I've done a playthrough of Heavy Rain on my channel, and as you can see, I've also made different playthroughs where I did the alternate choice scenes. You know, things could have turned out this way if I had, you know, Scott Shelby decide to kill this guy in the shop. If I decided that Norman Jaden never finds out the location of the warehouse because the leads he has are too weak, you know. I think Heavy Rain, the draw of that, the successful nature of it, was not that his story was great. I mean, it is a story-driven game, but even if his story was horrible and bad, it's still really impactful because the point is that you're interacting with the story. And I think before that point, I mean, plenty of games have done it even before, but Heavy Rain was the one game to like just bring the general gaming's consciousness, you know, to become aware of this and just be like, wow. And so by the time, you know, L.A. Noire came out, The Walking Dead, the game comes out, the public was ready to embrace and fall in love with those experiences. And if Heavy Rain was not a commercial or critical success, the impact of those feature games like the Walking Dead, I don't know. Would The Walking Dead have even been made this early in 2012, really? That's, you know, I think that's an arguable point that I would make, in that Heavy Rain may not have the best story, it may have all these plot holes and such, but it doesn't matter, because the experience of Heavy Rain is not just about the story that David Cage has written, but it's also what you can make out of that story, how you end up, the experience is there. And also the way, the most important thing I think with Heavy Rain, and I think David Cage actually succeeded, was that you end up kind of just connecting with these characters and seeing where they go and how you can kind of ship them, you know, the choices they make, the stories that you can connect, the story that you can conclude with in Heavy Rain, is mostly written by David Cage, so most of it is arbitrarily done and just shown to you like a movie. But at the same time, the great thing about Heavy Rain is that it feels like you had a hand in that. You felt like an editor of that somehow. Like, somehow, like, okay, Ethan ends up being married with Madison. And the killer ends up being killed by Lauren in the end. You know, that's something that, you know, is a scene that's just, you know, you just watch passively. But getting there, you know, determining that ending, I felt like I had a hand in that. And I think that is the main draw of the Heavy Rain experience. And I think when you consider that aspect of it, Heavy Rain, I think, was very innovative in what it accomplished. And its accomplishments, I think, definitely moved the medium forward. Even if, for example, the story is not, you know, he writes in the end of the blog, Macabre Milkman, he says, look, if Heavy Rain was a novel, it would have failed. If it was a movie, it would have failed. If anything else, if it was anything else because of his awful voice acting and an awful script, it would have just simply failed. But the point is, Heavy Rain is not a novel, it's not a movie, it's an interactive experience. And, you know, it may fail as a script, it may fail as a novel, but because of its compelling nature of interactive experience, it was poignant in the gaming landscape. It made a huge impact. You know, it made the gaming public, the mainstream gaming public, aware of these kind of games, and it kind of just allowed the mainstream gaming public to embrace more of these kind of unique kind of games. So I think its success as overall had a huge impact, which is what makes David Cage makes these kind of arrogant, pompous statements, or what seems like arrogant, pompous statements. And that's because Heavy Rain's success, he's able to do that because of the impact it had on the gaming industry. Whether you hate Heavy Rain as a game, as whether you hate Heavy Rain's story, I don't think you can deny that it had such an impact in the gaming industry. And that's my point, that's my response to his blog.